to start the first poetry of class 9th NCERT Beehive book. That is The Road Not Taken. This poem is written by Robert Frost, who was an American poet. His poetries were earlier published in England, but later on it was also published in America as well. Today we are going to discuss about the meaning of the poetry, what Robert Frost is trying to tell us about. He is trying to first tell us about the different choices, different kind of decisions which we have to take in our daily lives, where we have to decide between two given options and we have to sometimes take a tough choice as well. Let's see. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Yellow wood is forest here. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. So the poet is saying here is, two roads diverged in a yellow wood. So many times we have came to a place where two different roads are getting diverged from a single point of standing where we are exactly. Two different roads are going. In our daily lives as well, we have to decide which road we have to choose. So the poet is literally trying to give us that kind of a tough choice, where he is standing at a point from where two different roads are going, and he is supposed to choose, or we are supposed to choose one amongst that one. And be one traveler, long I stood. Being a traveler, the poet is standing there. He is just puzzled a little that how he is going to decide. And look down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Undergrowth is where the road is getting hidden. Basically, the road is ending that point of time. Till the time it is going to an end, the road is going to an end, the poet is just trying to do, he is trying to choose that which path he is going to choose. The less traveled one or the most traveled. Let's see. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. So the poet is saying, took the other just as fair. So he has chosen the second one rather the first one, as and he is just trying to clarifying it that what I have chosen as an option, that is pretty fair for me. I think it is a good option. And having perhaps the better claim, and I'm claiming it to be the better one, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Meanwhile, it was grassy. Which roads are generally grassy? Which is a less traveled one? Less traveled means a less number of people or very few number of people actually went on that road. In our daily lives as well, we can easily witness those roads which are less traveled, they are more grassy. And the poet is also choosing that one because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Meanwhile, so many people must have thought of it that this road is a little less traveled, so they just switched their choice and they opted for the first road, which the poet has ignored, or he has chosen it over the second one, which is a less traveled and grassy. Moving to the next paragraph. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Trodden black is basically those leaves which were a little crushed, a little faded, dried one. But because it is laying on the road, no one has crushed over it, no one has just went over it. So it is just lying on that road which the poet has chosen. Oh, I kept the first for another day. And what he is saying, he is just trying to justify his own soul that I have given myself a conscience. What is that? That some next kind of time I will choose the first one, the first road which today I have not opted for. Yet knowing how way leads on to way. When we start traveling, when we start taking decisions, when we start going somewhere, we are not aware that whether it is going to be a success, it's going to be a failure, but it needs so much of courage to put so much of effort in making that decision. So here the poet is also saying the same thing, yet knowing how way leads on to way. He is not aware where he is going to reach to his destination or he is going to fail. I doubted if I should ever come back. And in this line, he is talking about the first road which he actually has not chosen for today, and he has a doubt over it, whether he will come back to this road, the first one, or he is not going to come here again. Moving to the next stanza, I shall be telling this with a shy. Shy is what basically? Shy is a deep breath when we are trying to relax our body and our mind. I shall be telling this with a sigh, with a deep breath. The poet is trying to make himself understand somewhere ages and ages hence, after so many years, after so many days, or a long period of time after this day, he is saying, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. After ages, after years, a long period of time, he is saying that one day I will may think that that particular day, the choice which I made actually today where I am standing, that is the result of that particular choice which he actually chose. He did what exactly in the beginning, what we have discussed in the first stanza? He chose the first, he ignored the first one and chosen the second one, which was less traveled, while the rest of the people or other travelers has not chosen. So he is saying that after years, after so many years which has been passed, or after so many times, he will be regret. He is not sure about this feeling right now. It may be that he will be a little regretful about this decision, or maybe he will be happy that finally, from that point of time when I decided to travel this road, I have reached today what I am. So this was the poetry which was given to us by Robert Frost. He is famous for his writings in rural kind of passages, areas where he can connect our daily life, belongings and happenings. And this is the poem in which we are able to understand, from which we can easily figure out that we have to make different choices in our life. And from those small choices, what we do, either we achieve success, we achieve good destinations, we reach to good destinations or successful destinations, or sometimes we fail as well. But this is the thing life is all about. So I hope this poetry is clear to all of you. Thank you.